might not approve you, but thank God, if God approves you, then you know that you're on the right way in Jesus' name. Only faithful are overcome. Only the faithful are overcome. That's why Revelation 17, verse 14, how about Mesoma? Mesoma Anji? They will wage the war against the Lamb. But the Lamb will triumph over them. Why? Because He is the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. Listen. And, listen here. And with Him will He call the chosen and faithful followers. We are followers of Jesus Christ. So the follower of Jesus Christ, Bible says that they are overcomers. So it's very good for us to know that faithfulness is for those people who are overcomers in Jesus' name. And since you are overcomers, continue to be faithful and you're going to enjoy the result that are there as you continue to do the Lord's assignment in Jesus' name. God never commit Himself or His resources to anyone who is not faithful. God, you never commit Himself or His resources to anyone who is not faithful. Mungu wetu hatakupatia resources zake if you are not faithful. Ujue ya kwamba Mungu wetu anasema ya kwamba tukiwa faithful na kidogo, we will be faithful to much. Yote ya kwamba Mungu wetu anatuangalia kila siku. Mungu wetu anatuangalia kila mchana. Ya kwamba vile ametuita katika huduma yake, na ile pesa ametupatia, na wale watu ametupatia, na ile ministry ambayo Mungu ametupatia kila mmoja wetu. Are we faithful to where God has put you? Pahali huko katika church yenu, pahali huko katika ile ministry Mungu amekupatia, pahali niko katika ile ministry Mungu ametupatia, am I faithful to that area where God has assigned me? Ya ukia kwa sababu mwulisa wewe, hapo Mungu amekuweka, are you faithful? Ukua faithful na kidogo, Mungu hata kupatia, if you're not faithful to the little, you cannot be faithful to much. That's why God say that God does not, number three, God never commit Himself or His resources to anyone who is not faithful. Kama utakuwa faithful na kidogo, hutatoka pale. Sami, B. Regina. Kama utakuwa faithful na kidogo, na uonekane ya kwamba you can be faithful too much. If you are not faithful to what God has assigned you, you will never be there. Utakuwa tu pale. You will never go ahead. You will never have what we call the next level. Utakuwa tu pale, unafanya kitu inaitwa stagnation. Ya ukia mwenzako mwambie, stagnation is not your portion. Come on, say, stagnation is not my portion. Na kwa sababu stagnation is not my portion, then we need to understand the assignment that God has given us. We must be faithful to what we have and then continue going forward and going forward and going forward in Jesus' name. I remember when I started preaching here, I started preaching around here. That is over 46 years ago or 47 years ago. I was a young man, and now I'm 71 years now. So you can say, I was a young man. Here I am, years ago I am a son. But I was faithful to God here in the year 47 here in Mwana. Na hakuna mtu alikuwa anakaribia injili. Sasa, miaka hiyo yote, nikiangalia, hata watu wale wako katika hii mizi, hata wengine siwajui. Katika hii region ambaye naongoza, hata wengine siwajui. Siwajui, I don't know them. Even pastors, I don't know them. Even leaders, I don't know them. In this region I am. If you're faithful to kidogo, you believe too much.
Amen.
Might okay. So, So let us not despise ourselves. Be faithful of what you are doing, and God will continue extending your boundary in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Turn to a neighbor and tell neighbor, even if you are not near me, don't stagnation is not your gift. Hallelujah. May the Lord help us to move forward in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That's much for today. Are you in the camp? Not so many who followed Jesus Christ qualified to be his in a circle. Not many people who followed Jesus Christ were in the inner circle. You understand? It was only Peter, John, and James who qualified to be in the inner circle. Esther, what about what were the followers of Jesus? Those followed him. They were there and they saw the miracle, they saw the wonder, they saw the dream of the Lord, but only very few people were in the circle of Jesus. That is Peter, John, and James. Oh, that. How do you report what you are? Series of Jesus. What are you giving? How do you do a series of Jesus? At a project. That's why Peter, John, and James, they were the only guys who qualified to be in the inner circle of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Peter and John and James, they were the only guys who were in the inner circle of Jesus Christ. And remember how many people followed Jesus Christ. The rest were not faithful. May the Lord help you and help me to be faithful, that we can be able to be in the circle of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Na ukiwa katika ile circle ya Yesu utakuwa ukijua nini kitu naitwa nini siri ya Mungu wetu. Okay, I want to be in the circle of Jesus.